Hi, this is Josh from JoshBuilds, and today I'm going to be showing you how to build a USB-powered air conditioner. Now, because I want to get into the build quickly, I only show a quick demo, but if you stay with us till the end, you can see the full demo and how much it cools by. Now, before we get into the build, I just want to show some of the science behind what we're going to be using for this air conditioner. These are Peltier elements, and they have the property that when you apply electricity to the terminals, it creates a difference in temperature. That means one side gets hot and one side gets cold. And in this case, it is the top side that will get cold. They also work in the opposite direction. I use them in another one of my videos titled, How to Make a Heat Charger. And in that one, I use a temperature difference to produce electricity. So first we're going to start off with two heat sinks. If you don't have heat sinks, you can use copper pipes and flatten them out. I attach these together with an elastic band and put Peltier elements in on each side. I want to make sure the same side is facing up for both of them. After holding them in with elastics, I'm going to wire them together, positive to positive, negative to negative. Now I'm going to cut out a base for them. After cutting out the base, we are going to be putting the heatsink contraption with the Peltier elements into the styrofoam base. This will make it so that one side of it will become hot, one side will become cold, and they will be separated by the styrofoam base. And the idea is, we basically want to use the cold dispersed by the cold side of the Peltier elements to cool, and keep it separate from the hot side so we can disperse the hot air somewhere else. So, as you can see, we're trying to make it airtight by gluing it all the way around. I'm going to attach a motor. This is going to be used to blow the cool air. I'll glue this fan into place. Now I'm going to wire the fan in parallel as well with our Peltier elements. In a container. This container here was just a peanut butter can with the bottom cut off of it. I'll glue it into place so nothing rattles around. Now I'm going to get a USB cord. Any USB cord you have laying around, or buy one from the dollar store. And I'll split the ends of it to grab a positive and negative wire, which will be the red and black one. Now I'm going to wire this up to the Peltier element and motor attachment we have. Wiring it the opposite way will just make the opposite side cold and the motor spin in the opposite direction. Now I'm going to glue a piece of styrofoam over, and this is going to be on the hot side, and this is because we don't want the hot air to exit, because then it would just be counterproductive. We'd be both cooling and heating up the air, which would cancel out. And now I put a tube in on the hot side so the hot air can be vented somewhere else. Now to test it out, first we're going to measure the air temperature. It's about 84 degrees or so. Now when we plug it in, the temperature will quickly start to decrease. This is partially because I had it plugged in before, so it was already kind of cold off the start. It'll normally take a few more seconds before it starts to cool down. And as you can see, the temperature will continue to decrease until it reaches 78 degrees. So the air conditioner cooled it about 5 degrees, which which is all right. Now that's its limit because the Peltier element and heat sink assembly can only cool the air so fast as it's traveling past the heat sinks. If you were to put more voltage and amperage in there, it would cool the air more. Now it maxes out at 78 degrees, that's our maximum cooling. So I fast forward through this, but then I try something new. I place the temperature probe against the top of the Peltier elements, and as you can see, they are a little colder. Now that's because even though they are colder, they can only cool the air so fast. So they are about 74 degrees, but can only cool the air to 78 degrees before it's finished flowing over them, which is a cooling of 5 degrees, and the healthy elements cool themselves a little more. Thanks for watching to the end of my video. Feel free to like and subscribe and check out ways to support me to help me make more cool and better videos like this one. To see my other projects and buy parts you might need, you can check out my channel or my website joshbuilds.com. You can also follow me on my social networks to keep updated with my new content. Thanks.